Come on. Right where you are, just begin to worship our great God. Hallelujah. The song says, oh Lord, we give you praise and Lord, we bless your name. We lift our voices just to say thank you for your mercy towards us, for your goodness and your mercy, Lord, toward us, we I know you know it. Come on, sing.
Oh Lord, we give you praise. And yes, we do. mercy. Trust us in the midst of a pandemic, God. We just thank you for your goodness, Jesus, and your mercy, oh God, towards us. Yes, we do. For your goodness, you keep opening our eyes, God. We thank you for your mercy towards us. You keep on looking beyond our faults and seeing our needs. Oh, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your goodness and your mercy, yes, towards us. I can't say thank you enough, Jesus. We offer you praise. Right there's a good time to just lift your hands and give God glory. Hallelujah, we offer you praise, God. We offer you
Good morning, Carter. This is Calvin Patillo coming to you with this morning's prayer. I hope that everyone had a wonderful Christmas, and I look forward to a very good Happy New Year. As we say goodbye to the year of 2020, you, like me, are probably very happy to say goodbye to 2020, considering all the things that have gone on. This was a difficult year for most of us. I would probably dare say all of us in some form or fashion. I'm pretty sure that the difficulties and the things that we had to go through were different from one person to the next, but I'm pretty sure in saying that for most of us this year was very difficult. The good news is for believers, we know that God is still in control regardless of what the election results are, regardless of what is happening with coronavirus or whatever is happening within the world that we live. God is still in control. That's where our hope is. That's where our happiness is. And so as we prepare to say goodbye to 2020, a lot of us are excited about saying that, but we also should be equally as excited about the year 2021. And not just because it's the new year, but the fact that God is still in control. God still has some new beginnings for each of us, regardless of what the new year is. But there's some things that God is continuously working with in us. And so as we bring this year to a close and we look forward to next year, I thought that this prayer would be really geared towards new beginnings. So let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity to just simply say thank you. We thank you for allowing us to see us through this year of 2020. And Father God, we look forward to 2021. We thank God that you've been able to keep us alive, keep us well, keep us safe. But most importantly, Father God, we thank you for the fact that you still reign supreme. You are still King. You are still God. You are still all powerful. You are still here. And for that, we say thank you. As we look forward to new beginnings, whether it is new opportunities professionally, new relationships, even if it's new opportunities, Lord, just to give you thanks and to praise your name, we thank you for these new beginnings. We look forward to these new beginnings. As believers, having the hope that things won't stay the same is the hope that we have as believers. And because of that, we just continue to say thank you. Father God, as we do away with those things that we're ready to rid ourselves of, as we're making decisions about what is to occur for us in 2020, we just simply ask that you continue to walk with us and talk with us and guide us in the way that you would have us to go. Father God, most importantly, we want to be obedient to what you have in store for us, and we need to be able to listen to what it is that you have for us and to be obedient to it. Lord, we thank you in advance for what you have in store for all of us. And most importantly, we thank God for what you have in store for Carter Metropolitan CME Church. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to just simply say thank you once again. And we thank God for the opportunity to see not only a new day, but 2021. We look forward to what you have in store. All these things we ask in your Son Jesus' name, we pray. Thank God, thank God, thank God.
Good morning, Carter family. My name is David Valentine II, and I will be leading us in the responsive reading this morning. And the scripture will be taken from 1 John chapter 5, verses 1 through 12. Again, that is 1 John chapter 5, verses 1 through 12. And I will be reading from the Message translation. And it goes as such. Every person who believes that Jesus is, in fact, the Messiah, is God begotten. If we love the one who conceives the child, we'll surely love the child who was conceived. The reality test on whether or not we love God's children is this. Do we love God? Do we keep his commands? The proof that we love God comes when we keep his commandments, and they are not at all troublesome. Every God-begotten person conquers the world's ways. The conquering power that brings the world to its knees is our faith. The person who wins out over the world's ways is simply the one who believes Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus, the divine Christ, he experienced a life-giving birth and a death-killing death. Not only birth from the womb, but baptismal birth of his ministry and sacrificial death. And all the while, the Spirit is confirming the truth, the reality of God's presence at Jesus' baptism and crucifixion, bringing those occasions alive for us, a triple testimony, the Spirit, the baptism, the crucifixion, and the three in perfect agreement. If we take human testimony at face value, how much more should we be reassured when God gives testimony, as he does here, testifying concerning his Son. Whoever believes in the Son of God inwardly confirms God's testimony. Whoever refuses to believe, in effect, calls God a liar, refusing to believe God's own testimony regarding his Son. This is the testimony in essence. God gave us eternal life. The life is in his Son. So whoever has the Son has life. Whoever rejects the Son rejects life. The word of God for the people of God, and we all say together, thanks be to God.
Good morning. My name is Robert Harris. I'm asking that you please join me this morning. In whom do we believe in? I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
The end of Advent also signals the end of another year. Advent reminded us that Jesus has come into our world to change it. The hope, joy, peace, and love of Advent should lay the foundation for our lives, as well as the new year that we find ourselves about to enter. 2020 was not the year that anyone thought it would be. It was fierce and ferocious. It was hard and heavy. It was filled with sickness and transitions of all kinds. 2020 was rough. But 2020 also forced us to rely on our faith, to take prayer seriously, appreciate our friends and loved ones, and even embrace new ways of being and gathering. 2020 taught us that even in spite of fear, uncertainty, sickness, and even death, we can still have life and have it more abundantly. You know, it's interesting that on New Year's Eve, we have all these traditions of celebration. Maybe we would watch the ball drop in Times Square, or after the countdown, we would scream Happy New Year and blow party favors and sing Auld Lang Syne, all because we were celebrating an end as well as a new beginning. A beginning that was filled with unknown challenges and joys and sorrows, highs and lows, births and even deaths. Think about it. We never really know what a new year will hold. But on New Year's Eve, we all prepare to greet the new year with celebration, with hope, with joy, and with an expectation of love. Listen, if 2020 beat you up and shook you around, you may not be interested in a message of hope and expectation. If 2020 broke your heart, you may not have any room to receive the fact that God is love. If you're struggling with fear and anxiety, frustration and anger, I want you to know that you are not alone. Listen, you can love God and be mad. Mm-hmm. You can love God and wrestle with your emotions. You can love God and admit that you are scared of the unknown. Watch this. Your humanness does not intimidate the God who created you in his incredible image. No matter what you had to face in 2020, you didn't do it by yourself, but God was present with you every step of the way. The omniscient God Almighty stood on the brink of 2019, knowing all about your 2020. Watch this. When you won, God clapped for you. When you lost, God cried with you. When you were empty, God poured into you. And even though you struggled, even though you fought, even though you felt stretched beyond your capacity, God's hand was ever upon you. God never lost his grip, even when you let go of his. Jesus came into the world to be God with us. And that's why we can celebrate. That's why we can shout, we can worship and give thanks, because we have a testimony. We have proof that God keeps his promises. God was with us all 2020 long. And God will be with us no matter what 2021 has to offer. Our scriptural encouragement for the morning comes from the book of Hebrews, the 13th chapter. I believe with my whole heart that this passage of scripture will help to lay the foundation for our new year in life and spirit. This is how the Passion Translation begins, right at the first verse. No matter what, make room in your heart to love every believer and show hospitality to strangers, for they may be angels from God showing up as your guests. Identify with those who are in prison as though you were there suffering with them, and those who are mistreated as if you could feel their pain. When you make room in your heart to love, you set a good foundation for your new year. When you love people, not just tolerate them. When you love people, not just put up with them momentarily, you make room for blessing. Why? Because your Bible says that when you love people and you show grace to them, you just might be entertaining angels. Watch this. What if we've mistreated some angels? What if we've mishandled some folk that God had sent to bless us, my God? What if we've misjudged the intentions of some folk that God has positioned to open doors for us? When you love people, you don't have time to get caught up in things that divide and divert you from your purpose. When you love people, you don't have time to measure yourself according to the standards of others because you are so busy trying to live up to God's standards. When you dare to love, you see people for who they are and you love them anyway. When you love intentionally, you can hear the hearts of people, even if their tone conveys a different message. When you love radically, you trust that God will provide every increase necessary so you don't have to waste your time rationing out your love. The scripture says, make room in your heart for love. But how do you do it? Well, you ask God to remove the stuff that blocks your capacity to love. And we've all got some stuff that tries to stand in the way of our love. Listen, we've all got some history, some thoughts, some issues, some reasons that keep us from loving in ways that can change the world. But let me tell you what the world needs now. What your family needs now, what God's church needs now more than anything else is for you to be committed to love. A kind of love that suffers with those who suffer, cries with those who are crying, prays for those who are in need, and stands with those who are enduring hardship like good soldiers. The text goes on to say this at verse 5. Don't be obsessed with money, but live content with what you have, for you always have God's presence. For hasn't he promised you, I will never leave you alone, never, and I will not loosen my grip on your life. Oh, that's real good. The next thing I need you to do is if you really, really want to set a good foundation for your new year, then you've got to be content with what you have. Why? Because you always have God's presence. Let's just be honest. How many of us spent a considerable amount of time in 2020 upset and irritated because of what we didn't have, what we couldn't do, and where we couldn't go? How many of you can testify that you spent some time in 2020 obsessing about the money you didn't have or the money you needed to keep or the money that was promised that never made it into your account? In this particular letter to the Hebrews, Paul encourages us to stop obsessing, stop fixating on, stop allowing yourself to be preoccupied with money and be content with what you have. Watch this. Money isn't the only thing that we obsess over. We obsess over our children, our careers, our future. We even obsess over time. But the word of God for us this morning is to be content with what we already have. Now is the time for us to celebrate and appreciate and be thankful for what we already have. Come on, y'all. God has blessed us. God has covered us. God has kept us. God has provided for us. God has sustained us. God is restoring us. Paul takes it a step further to remind us that on top of everything else we have, we also have God's presence. In the presence of the Lord is the fullness of joy. God's presence is power. God's presence is peace. God's presence is healing. God's presence is protection and grace. God's presence is the only accompaniment that is consistent and enduring. Not only is God's presence with you, but Deuteronomy 31 and 8 says that the Lord himself goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Isaiah 52 and 12 says that you won't go out in a rush, nor will you run away, because the one going before you is the Lord. Your rear guard is the God of Israel. So listen, the Lord is with you. The Lord goes before you. The Lord stands behind you. That means that you are covered and protected on all sides. That means that provision and grace shields you in your going out and in your coming in. If you've got the presence of the Lord, you have everything you need to make it through unknown and unexpected situations. If you've got the presence of the Lord, you have everything that you need to make it through many dangers, toils, and snares. Listen, if you've got the presence of the Lord, you've got power, you've got strength, you've got hope, you've got what it takes to endure even until the end. Verse 6 says, so we can say with great confidence, I know the Lord is for me, and I will never be afraid of what people may do to me. Listen, I think your 2021 will get off to a great start if you can make up your mind to affirm this decree that Paul lays out for us in verse 6. I know the Lord is for me, and I will never be afraid of what people may do to me. Oh, I feel like preaching now. Listen, I know that the Lord is for me. I know that the Lord is for me. Y'all say it with me. I know that the Lord is for me. Listen, it doesn't matter who's against me, because I know that the Lord is for me. It doesn't matter what folks say about me, because I know that the Lord is for me. Listen, you better learn how to get yourself into a mirror and talk to yourself. I don't care what it looks like, the Lord is for me. I don't care what it feels like, the Lord is for me. I know that the Lord is for me because he called me by name. I know that the Lord is for me because he wants me to prosper even as my soul prospers. I know that the Lord is for me because he keeps on doing great things for me. The enemy can set his traps, and sickness can make its threats. Issues can attempt to shake my foundation, but the Lord is for me. And if God is for me, then he's more than the world. He's more than the sickness. He's more than the trouble against me. Come on, you ought to be shouting right there. Beloved, I said all of that to get to this final verse in the text, which is verse 8. Simply says, Jesus, the anointed one, is always the same yesterday, today, and forever. Listen, I know that 2020 was rough for all of us. And I know that 2020 had too many twists and turns. I know that 2020 introduced so many changes into our lives. But listen, we've got a reason to celebrate. We've got a reason to trust God, because no matter what has changed in our lives, Jesus has remained the same. Listen, there were changes in our economy, but Jesus remained the same. There were changes in our social interactions, but Jesus remained the same. There were changes in how we did church, but Jesus remained the same. Listen, Jesus is still a way maker. He's still a miracle worker. He's still a promise keeper. He's still the one who puts the broken and cracked pieces of our lives back together. Listen, if he did it before, there's no doubt in my mind that he can do it again. I want to encourage you this morning that God is still the God who opens doors. God is still the God who mends broken hearts. He's still the God who sends peace that surpasses all understanding. He's still the God who brings order to chaos. The songwriter said, when the world is shaking, heaven stands. When my heart is breaking, I'll never leave God's hands. Listen, it's good to know that no matter what we have to face, God is with us. It's good to know that no matter what happens to us, God goes through it with us. And that's why we can celebrate walking in the direction of a new beginning that has some uncertainties and a few unknowns. Listen, we don't have to withhold our celebration. We don't have to be bitter because of our past, because if we get new mercy every time we get a new day, what kind of mercy do you think we're going to get when God gives us a brand new year? Jesus Christ is the same. He's still mighty. He's still wise. He's still powerful. He's still able. and Jesus will remain the same 2020 and beyond. Thank you for joining us for this 40th episode of PowerPoints. Listen, I want to thank God for such an awesome team that helps to give this ministry momentum every single week. If you're interested in joining us on air as a worship leader, please don't hesitate to drop us a line at powerpoints1510@gmail.com. The process is easy and our wonderful production staff is ready to help you at any time. Finally, thank you so much for your overwhelming support of Lessons and Carols. Let me shout out all of the anointed singers, musicians, special guests, and the team who worked so hard to put everything together. You can be on the lookout for more exciting worship and fellowship opportunities all 2021 long. Stay tuned. Now, hope that you're ready to receive the benediction. I want you to look me in my face and hear me when I say to you that it is my prayer to God that the Lord bless you and keep you, that the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you, that the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon all of you and give you peace. That's the way Bishop would do it. But here's what I'm going to say. I pray that you would lay the foundation for your new year with celebration, love, and with the reality that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Now, unto him who's able to do exceeding and abundantly above all that you could ask or think, be glory, honor, majesty, dominion, and power now, henceforth, and forevermore. And all God's people said amen and amen. We'll see you in 2021.